Now, this is the Marian University Coaches Show.
Welcome to the Marian University Coaches Show. Will Hamp, along with Carson Harris and Katie Gerrals. Basketball, we're into February. What'd they say? I saw it on Twitter that the groundhog saw his shadow, so that means six more weeks of basketball at Marian University, right? Make it happen, correct?
Well, let's hope so.
Let's make that work. Well, this week you guys are back home against Spring Arbor. I think last Saturday, maybe it was this show, Coach, but we told people we need a big crowd. We want you out there. And I thought the crowd was pretty good last Saturday, and we won it again this Saturday.
They were awesome. They were awesome. And I know our guys fed off of it and Katie's girls as well. So we would definitely love to have that group back out there yelling loud, getting everybody excited.
Yeah, get loud, be proud, make it happen. And let's talk about three victories this week from last week's show to now, starting with you, Coach, last night, Wednesday night at IWU. A little payback for Indiana Wesleyan. That was special.
Yeah, that's a tough place to play, tough team to play against. They zoned us for about 38 minutes, 39 minutes. So it's, and they're long and big and tough to score against in the half court. We got to run there to start the fourth quarter and finish it on the defensive end.
Get the win, 61-56. Kirkhoff scored 17. Kelly's going to join us later on the show. But you improved to 12-1 in the crossroads. We don't want to say all but wraps it up, but that's a huge win as far as trying to get this number one seed.
Yeah, it's a huge win because they're in second, and it gives us a three-game lead with five to go. So if we can take care of ourselves, then we don't have to worry about getting help from anybody else. Obviously, the next one is the important one, and that's Saturday with Spring Arbor.
Yep. Coach Harris, big win. I love to talk about this game against Taylor, going back to Saturday. That was really – you guys, 66% from the floor. That was as you draw it up, right, in practice. That's the way you play basketball.
Yeah, I think it was exciting to watch. It was fun to watch. And our guys did a great job. But the best thing about it, when you're shooting that well, you're shooting shots that are open. You're not shooting a lot of contested shots. Now, we made a few of them that were contested, but guys were unselfish, made plays, and we took a lot of shots that were us, standing there. It's almost like you're alone in the gym knocking shots in. So they did a great job.
Yeah, against Taylor, you guys won it 97-79. A lot of people want to talk about James Crowley and his 26 points. That was pretty cool. But what about Patty Bell, the way he played? He came out strong. He was a man child.
He did a great job. Offensive rebounds. We play really well when he makes some. He made a lot of plays on Saturday that way. But a few of those a game are really helpful from him. No missed shots, I believe, the whole game. So did a great job and gave us a great boost. The way he played and outside of that, he was really talkative and smart with our game plan. At one point, he actually pointed out that he needed to come out because he knew he had a bad matchup on the defensive end. So, I was really impressed with that as well.
Yeah, and sticking with Taylor last Saturday, you guys got a win against an improving basketball team. I mean, one thing about Taylor, they are getting better, and they are a threat to you guys, aren't they?
They're a tough matchup. They're fours and fives all. They shoot the three. They space the floor. They put a lot of shooters on the floor. Good athletes to drive it to the rim. Just a tough matchup for us. We weren't great, but we told our kids after the game, the mark of a good team is finding ways to win when you don't play your best. I was very much under the weather that day, and the girls and my staff held it down. So, a huge shout out to them.
Jess scored 30 in that, but just overall, it was a nice win. And I think Jess went over 1,000 for her career. That's cool.
Yeah, to do it in 3 years is special. Wes is...
Wes Dowers did it in 2 years, got 1,000. Yeah, he also did that this week.
Wes is a little bit different animal there, but just proud of Jess because she's not a scorer. She just does so much for us. But that game against Taylor having 30 was huge. We needed every bit of it.
Both those wins this week, you had to play tough in the fourth quarter, and you did. You finished well.
Yeah, and that's how you win. That's how you win in February and March. You've got to be able to close out games. Hopefully come this month we can start piecing it together bit by bit. We got Kirby back in the lineup, so hopefully we get our rotation back going and figure out just find ways to keep winning.
Yeah, congrats to both Jess and also West Dowers for getting over 1,000 points in their career at Marian University. Let's switch gears real quick and talk football. National Signing Day was Wednesday, and the Marian Knights did a great job getting 40 new players, 37 freshmen, 3 transfers. Coach Mark Henninger likes this squad.
Well, I think we did a very good job of recruiting for need. You know, our coaches did a great job. You know, we sat down, you know, really sat down last spring, and we started to look at, you know, where are we wanting to target this year? What are we wanting to look at? And I think we were a little bit more selective this year than we've been in years past, you know, which is difficult, you know, because, you know, we had to turn away some really good football players. But very excited about the class that we have right now. I mean, I think, you know, when you look at what we need and what our needs are, not just for this upcoming fall, but, you know, 2-3 years down the road, I think we did a great job of answering a lot of those questions.
And a quick salute to Marian University's own Krishawn Hogan. Caught up with him today at Grand Park, where he's taking part in combine training with St. Vincent Sports Performance. This week, he was invited to the NFL Combine coming up in Indy later this month. Now, only about 300 college players in the nation get that invite. Look for more from Krishawn coming up on MUNights.com. How cool is that, Krishawn Hogan's going to the NFL Combine?
Yeah, Krishawn is special. He's just a, you know, a different guy, and we've been really lucky to have him here. Good kid, too. Great young man, and it's cool to know him.
Yeah, he is a great guy, and we wish him the best of luck. Real quickly, we're about to take a break, but coming up in the next segment, we're going to have Casey Earls and also Kelly Kirkhoff. Tell me about Casey. What's he all about?
Great young man out of Mooresville High School, great shooter, and just a kid who's fun to be around. Only see him growing as a Knight.
And Kelly?
We're on Kelly kid. We won't hold it against her, but she's just special. She, you know, she cleans the floor every night, and she's all over the place.
Kelly and Casey coming up as we continue right here on the Marian University Coaches Show.